And you know be my area father, but you must fight for me.
Hello, reboot.
Hello, baby, yo. How do you do? Show my family. Oh, you hear me see? I don't mind. Why shall I shy? Show my family. You hear me see?
Good day and welcome to the program. You can't wait to have on your screen when each day becomes. And of course, you know, when it is 2 p.m. on dot, it is time for your favorite and award-winning program, Entertainment Splash, live on Union Show TV. I am your host on today's edition, Olatoye Edupe. Call me T.Y. or Don Pablo, I wouldn't be wrong. However, need I reiterate that it is not an exaggeration, but a statement of fact when I say today's package is loaded with a whole lot of news stories, trendy gists, gossips, as well as a highly controversial segment where we discuss on highly controversial issues of societal and national importance. More so, I'm not alone in the studio, as I'm in company of wonderful personalities, and together we'll be running the program to your satisfaction, just the way you want it. Hi guys, how are you doing today?
I'm fine. Thank you.
Cool. I can see you guys are looking jiggy, like.
Where
is it happening now? Like,
that's coming out from the state, actually.
Wow.
Oklahoma.
Wow. So,
nice being on the show. My name is Oluwadara Ridota, aka Abby.
I'm Olabam Jito. He come to be you to the box of talks.
Hi, guys. It's your girl, O to the L to the U to the C, H, and I, Oluchi.
Wow.
And it's nice being on the show with you guys.
Wow, nice one. Like, how was the weekend on your side? You're looking good.
Thank you. I spend time with my family, though. So, it's just, family comes first. So,
yeah,
I spend time with them.
Wow. Yeah, it was cool. You know, just
like,
cool weekend after the
cinema.
Yeah, now we have to flex, you know.
So, BOT.
It's cool now, just hanging out with friends. Only weekend.
Wow. Luchi, how was it?
Just normal. I have to spend time with my family, you know. Family.
You're looking good, you know. You guys are looking good. Like,
thank you.
Well, all right. The program officially gets started with the first segment on the menu, which is the news and gist segment. But not after we come from this short musical break. So grab your seat and relax, as you don't want to miss out on it.
If I lose it all, will you still be there for me? If I don't get money, oh, will you still be loving me? If you knew my weakness, will you stand by me? See one bamba, me, Jao, show my shake, baby. So promise me.
Welcome back from the short musical break. That was Adekunle Gold featuring Simi on Promise Me. Like, those guys are the only moon. Yeah. they're not even having any of it. Like, we didn't even see that coming.
I didn't see that coming.
We're all expecting Fouls
and Simi. Do you get? Yes.
All of the story in there.
Adekunle Gold. Yes, I was expecting Fouls and Simi, but
okay. Wow.
It came like a bang.
Everyone was expecting Fouls, really. Like, yes. Well, straight up to the news and this segment. Well, our trendy story has the caption, Funke Akindele shows love to fans after hitting 8 million followers on Instagram. The excited screen diva celebrated this and praised the fans. Celebrities have, however, congratulated her on achieving this feat. Like,
8 million.
Funke Akindele is not a new person to the Nigerian music, like to the scene, the Nigerian industry. She's everywhere. You don't know Funke Akindele now is like a novice or something.
You're missing out. You don't know Funke Akindele.
Yeah.
Like, she's a living legend, actually. Anytime you hear Funke Akindele,
baddest.
You know, boom, Jennifer.
Jennifer's Diary, of course.
I think the 8 million is even small for her. Like, it's not. She wants more than that, like 8 million followers.
Yeah.
She's
very, very popular. No.
Very
and that giveaway, I am so taking part. I am taking part.
Me, I'm taking part. Like, what I feel about this 8 million followers, you know, right from I need to know. You understand? To Jennifer, popular, like Jennifer. And now to Jennifer Diary. I feel like she's giving us hit back to back.
Yeah,
yeah, so she deserves every good thing coming to our way.
Yeah.
Do you understand? And I feel like that 8 million followers is too small, but at least we need to also thank the fans.
Yeah, the fans are a big part. They're a big part of our
success
story.
Without her, without the fans, there won't be anything like Jennifer. Yeah, so I feel like our fans are.
You also have something?
No. She's cool. One love, Jennifer.
One love.
I love you.
And she's really doing it big in the industry. Yeah. Like, definitely, she's doing it big, seriously.
JJC.
Yes, and away from there, we move on to another gist which says AY Makun buys new luxury cars for himself and wife. The Nigerian comic act has left his fans and followers gushing after he shared a video of new luxury automobiles, multi-million automobiles in quotes, he purchased for himself and wife, Mabel Makun. Now, this brings us to the question of, I think, is it that most of the times our celebrities tend to flaunt their lifestyle, any new thing happening to them on the social media? You know, this passes certain signals. I don't know. This person has a signal, so like BOT, you know, being a guy today, bushy, just.
I think it's not everything you have to show people, like, it's not everything. There are some things you have to keep to yourself, like, I have you know, like, I have this, I have Rolex, I have this.
I totally object to it.
Really?
Wow.
Yes.
I think this gets to the third of
yes, I totally object to it because when, we know very well that when AY was suffering, you know, definitely we see people, you know, mocking him. And now that he has the money, please, AY, I'm telling you to your face or to the screen, please flaunt it.
I think I have something to say on this, but nevertheless, I feel as a celeb, you can look at it that way. You're posting, you know, celebrities are role models, people look up to them. Now, you're posting something out there on Instagram, Twitter, whatever you're passing a signal to somebody. Now, a person who is saying that could see it as, oh, I don't have as much as this. That's where people get into all these things.
That's when you work harder. That's when you work harder to aim it. Work hard.
I really think I'm going to go with yours because I feel, you have it. Flaunt it to an extent. This is Nigeria. People be like, oh, why are you beefing me? Oh, as they know, they just feel like you're trying to prove like you're bigger than
him. He needs to show his enemies that, baby, I have arrived. Don't you get this? Flaunt it.
No.
Do you think this is not contributing to any sort of. This is not contributing to any sort of wrong signal, like to prompt the youth to want to engage in things they're not to engage in?
That is if they want to now. That's if they want to. Okay. When you see something, you work hard to earn it. I feel like it's even advising the youth, like, okay, this is what I'm doing. I need you to work harder than this.
Yeah, that's true.
Okay. So please flaunt it, AY. Oppress the enemies. Yes, oppress them.
Okay. Picasso exits Olamide's YBL now record label. Energetic indigenous rapper Picasso penned a heartfelt farewell to the YBNL family on Twitter as he exits the record label. Now, this is something I found somewhat interesting. This is, if I'm right, like Picasso is like one of the budding talents in the industry currently, and he's leaving the YBNL family so soon. Just after how many months, we have the same case. We had the same case with Lighter, the same case with Adekunle Golden Chest. And I think this takes me to Lucci. Is it that these artists just go into slave contracts and they don't even know what they're going into?
I feel, first of all, the young artists, or let me say the unsigned artists, they need to have this patience. Do you understand?
Yeah.
They need to be patient enough, like they don't, not to enter a record label that won't suit them good.
Mm.
Because I feel like the other record label, like Maven Records, DMW, and they're really doing good. Before Tyra Savage and Ricardo Banks left Maven Records, they've gotten to this point, I can leave this thing. Do you understand? But let's come to the likes of Likesh.
Exactly.
Lighter, leaving the.
Lighter,
yes. Do we even know Lighter again right now? Because I feel like it's coming down.
It's still
giving us heat
now,
to heat again.
But on the other hand, I still feel you wouldn't even blame these artists because you know what the poverty is like in Nigeria now. Like, you won't tell me now I'm an upcoming artist and Badu just tell me, hey, but come, let me just sign you up. And I wouldn't even clear for the time.
Okay, but how do you feel when you when you just hit the limelight and then you back down immediately? It feels like, do you understand? So I feel like better for you not to even get signed at all.
Yeah, I think maybe the vibe, you know, they have an issue. Like,
exactly.
Which is unknown to us.
Olamide, please tell us.
Yeah, I think Olamide, tell us.
Olamide, tell us. You understand?
I give that straight to him.
Olamide, please tell us what is going on.
Poverty or no poverty, I feel if you are going into a record label, know what you want. Most people just go into the music industry like, yeah, I want to be popular.
Yeah,
and no, it's not meant to be like that.
Mm-hmm.
Right now, most record labels, they take like how many percent of the income coming
exactly.
in from all
like
the artists?
Yes.
They are gaining more than
more
the artists.
Agency.
So, well, that might be the reason, I can't say, but well, it's between
Olamide.
Though it's not quite clear, because Picasso has revealed that he's moving on to any other record label or releasing any new song soon. But well, we could only hope for the best.
Yeah,
we could only hope for the best. Now, we'll go back into BB Naija House if given another chance. Avala and Islomo review. BB Naija ex housemates Islomo and Avala talked about their experience in the house following Islomo and Avala's shocking eviction from the Big Brother Naija reality show, which made them the first two to leave the show. The beautiful ladies have spoken about how doubt made them feel. Now, there's an angle to this story I want us to look at. Like, these two ladies have complained about how, like, you were not given enough camera time.
Right.
Now, I know you're a big fan of Big Brother, but I'll come back to you. Like, they've complained about the fact that they were not given enough camera time, and the eviction was just so quick. Like, just in
first week. So cool. Just like going on an excursion, like
five days.
Just coming back. Like, not cool.
Now. So, what do you feel about this? Kind of too early.
Yeah, I think the Big Brother Nigeria needs like a platform for them, for the contestants to meet and get to know each other better than just going on a set, meeting different people from different area. Like, they can't really relate like very fast like that. What do you think?
To me, I feel like at first, you know, we have Double Wala, then we have Sigo Bay, and now we have the Pepe Dem.
Exactly.
So I feel like in those two last years, Miggy gave us 1 week grace for we the viewers to get acquainted to the new housemate. But this year was kind of, I don't know, like it was so trickish. I don't understand. You understand?
Probably I'm feeling this alone.
To me, I felt like okay, when Biggie evicted these people, there will be like a secret room. Normally, do you understand? But when I like, it was so real that they are going home for real, Biggie. Your rules are lit.
I feel they should extend the time frame. Because just 1 week, they should have given them grace of like 2 weeks, 3 weeks for the viewers to get used to them. But
yes.
Just 1 week.
1 week.
Yeah. Like you said, 5 days vacation.
5 days, like coming back.
Have you noticed, like, this year vibe of BB Naija is not there. Not like
that was what I was about to talk about. Like,
exactly.
Is it this year or what? Because the vibe, the paparazzi and everything.
Like the hype is just too much and
it went down.
Just
apart from that, it took so long for them to start. So everybody was just off it. Like the vibe is not there anymore.
Just
like,
bring it and let's just watch and
And if you notice. You really have slim girls there. Why not chubby people like the size?
I think they are
like body shaming. I show you what you're talking about.
Size people.
Yeah. Really, I think they are body shaming.
Now, do you have someone who you know you okay? I'm a big fan of this person. The house.
Definitely Messi.
Oh.
Messi.
Why Messi?
No. You have Messi. What else? Messi.
Yes.
Well, I think
our Messi.
Look, my Messi.
No, why Messi? Be hot. I mean, have be hot.
You didn't know from what.
Just
Messi. To me, I just feel like Messi is my own housemate because yes, she's my favorite. This girl is real. You know, she give it to you hot. When you give it to her hot, she give it to you hot. She's friendly. She has everything. You understand me?
Yeah, that's my Messi.
well, I can't just know that. I know that is not a big fan of Big Brother Naija.
I can't really say anything
about
this.
The vibe is out.
It's not like last year, so it's just
the vibe is out or not. I will watch it.
Well, Other gist has it that Zlatan releases new jam featuring Tiwa Savage titled Show Ton. Like, have you heard that?
Kappa,
of the moment now. Like,
yeah, definitely.
Like, you know, you, I know you have some of the slams.
Yeah,
like,
sure.
Give me one of
them. I
and that was really a hot jam.
Yeah, it's very cool.
It was on my playlist for the weekend. Yeah, I was listening to it over and over again. Like, put it on the
beat. We all know who Zlatan is.
And yes. Savage.
We all know Zlatan is. So, you know, Zlatan has also come a long way due to the limited space of time. Do you get? And I feel like with the limited space of time, he has given us hits back to back. You know, dancing to his songs and also bringing new dance for us. So for him to collaborate with the A-list artists in Nigeria is like a big bang to him. Yeah. So kudos to him. Yes. Hit back to back.
That brings us to the end of the news Ajik segment. Up next is another interesting segment where we'll be discussing on the big issue, as well as taking the reactions of students on the issue at hand. Stay glued to your CV sets as we go on this short musical break. We'll be right back.
Je m'appelle baby, so much of my loss, my loss. If you no get money, alone, mama, if you did your bakurumo, the wicked producer like in the mall. See what it is, Pokodomo, the baby, I like that. Oh, no, yeah, my sherry, quickly, my sherry, mumini, baby, baby, baby.
Welcome back from that musical break. What we'll be looking at on this segment today is the mixed reactions on the trending dubstep jam released by Afis Fashola, popularly known as Naira Marley, which has hit the Nigerian music scene, as well as the effects of the dubstep titled Sopi on the Nigerian youths. Guinness World Record dancer Kefi has criticized this dubstep and as well, in her comments, expressed her disgust over the masturbation-themed dubstep popularized by Naira Marley, saying, and I quote, "The dance is against what we should preach with a dance step, and it's totally absurd to have come from an adult as him." That is Naira Marley in quotes now. In the same vein, Naira Marley reacted to the comments of Kefi in a recent video where he blasted her, saying, "You have gone past your generation. People no longer enjoy your dance steps. You are one outdated..." God, bitch. Like, That's ash. Now, the question is, has the Sopi dance had a good effect amongst the Nigerian youths? Now, should it be banned from the Nigerian music scene? Before I take the views or thoughts of my co-host, let's go listen to students of Osun State University, Ikere Campus, about their views on this.
Actually, I think the Sopi dance is not something like, it's not something that should be like to be seen. Like, even when I don't know much, but I actually think it's not a good idea. I'm just dancing, singing, even the children too, that I don't know much. And that's what's the meaning of the thing. It doesn't make sense.
Sufi dance is just like any other dance. I don't see anything wrong with Sufi dance. It depends on your personality. I don't think a dance can influence you. It depends on your personality. I think Sufi dance is just like any other dance.
I think Sufi dance has bad effects on Nigerian youth because of the way they even portray the dance. Like, you know, now the way they do their hands and the way they brace their legs and everything like that. So I don't advise youth to dance that kind of song or anything like that.
Technically, Sufi dance would be regarded as a very disgusting dance, but in the same sense, we've seen one corner dance, we've seen shocky dance, and no one ever condemned those dance. This is Nigeria, and we're Malians. We can do this kind of dance, and it depends on the way you do it. So, personally, in my own view, I believe Sufi dance, like every other dance, is an Afro-pop dance, and as a Malian, I'll keep on doing Sufi dance. Personally, as an introvert, Sufi dance can, if you can easily get influenced by with Sufi dance, and as an extrovert, you can also influence people with Sufi dance. But still, in the same sense, the same wise, Sufi dance doesn't describe the kind of person that you are. So whether you do it, whether you're a bad person or a good person, Sufi dance doesn't determine that. Sufi dance is just a dance that we do and we still keep on doing.
Actually, I don't really like the dance, and I don't see it as something that people should actually dance, cause.